Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Oh. Yes, sir.
There is some problem, internet problem, that's why I am late. Good afternoon. I request all of you mute, at first mute. Am I audible? Can I start?
Yes, sir.
So today we are going to learn the new topic, that is age estimation, and it is on a ossification of the bones. Till now we are dealing with an important topic in an identity chapter, that is age estimation. In age estimation, two lectures have been covered. First lecture, the age estimation with different parameters. Parameters are the general characteristic or physical characteristic of an individual. Second thing is that of the age estimation from the dental status. And one lecture on forensic odontology I have been taken. In that, what are the different nomenclature of the teeth? When the temporary teeth get erupted, when the permanent teeth get erupted, all these things we have learned in the last lecture. Today we are going to see the important topic, that is the age estimation from the ossification of bones. So you all have studied the bones in anatomy, but that perspective is different. That in anatomy you have said, what are the different anatomical parts? What are the muscle attachment? What is the nerve supply? All these things you have learned in a first year. But in forensic medicine, you are going to learn in a bone that how from the bone age can be estimated. And this age estimation, ossification, appearance of the ossification center depend upon a different parameters. That is, it depends upon the race. It depends on the sex, and you all know that the ossification center get fused early in a female as compared to that of the male. Also, it depends upon the food habit, nutritional status of that individual, also hormonal and metabolic disorders. Then Indian ossification activities appears earlier than the Western population. So these all things you have to keep in mind. And again, I'm repeating that, considering all these scientific bases, that is general features, that is dental eruption of different teeth and the ossification center, even if you consider all these three characteristics, no doctor on the world can give the exact age of that individual. For the giving, the age you have to give in a range. And in a live person, up to 21 years, that is the range is given plus minus 1 year. Means you have to give in like a 16 years to 18 years. Like this, means plus minus 1 year. And after that, in a live, practically speaking, we give the age that individual is more than 21 years. So up to 21 years, practically, we give the opinion, that is ranging plus minus 1 year. That concept must be clear. And second concept, that these ossification center, whatever now I am telling, that also taken from a standard book, that is the Apurvanandi. If you are going to read from another book, you will see the difference of plus minus 1 year here and there. So even if in examination or in a court, you are asked, you have to give the reference of that standard textbook, that I have taken all these value from this standard textbook. So if you carefully see, or if you carefully read different books, then you will know that there is difference of plus minus 1 year. So whenever you are giving opinion of an age on ossification center, then you should give the reference that all these figures, all these values I have taken, it is from this standard textbook. Why I am repeating? Because you will see that there is a different figures are given in each textbook. And it depends, because this Apurbanandi has studied all these ossification center from West Bengal. So that is the study or whatever the range is given, it depends upon the West Bengal. If another researcher or another, that is Dr. Bardale's book is there, he may have taken the values from a Maharashtrian. So from this, there is plus minus 1 year difference is there. That also you should keep in a mind while you are giving opinion about the age estimation in first in exam or afterwards when you are doing the practice, then the in a quote also you have to quote that I have taken these figures from this and this standard textbook. Is it clear? And second thing, you all know that these in a female's ossification center comes early as well as fuses early. So the height of a female is usually less than of a male. So also remember that the fusion of an ossification center appears early in a female as compared to that of the male. 1 year here and there. Now, no need to mug up all these ossification center. You at first listen carefully my lecture and afterwards you read carefully from a standard textbook, you will get the understanding. Is it clear? Now I am going to elaborate as one bone by one bone and what are the different ossification center at first come and when they get fused. Is it clear? Can I proceed? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now first bone I am taking that of the humerus. You know humerus has head as well as it has lower end, and lower end has also the four parts. What are these parts? I am going to take. So in a head, so the first the head comes, appears at 1 year. After that comes the lesser greater tubercle, that is 4 years, and the lesser tubercle, that is the 5 years. So 1, 4, 5. These are the appearance. And these all three get fused to the shaft in a case of female, that is 15 to 16 years. And I already said in case of male at the 16 to 17 years. Is it clear? That is head come at the first year, greater tubercle at 4 years, lesser tubercle at 4. All these three get fused at the shaft at a 15 to 16 years in a female, while that of a male in 16 to 17 years. Then the lower end, at first the capitulum comes at the first year, then comes medial epicondyle at the 6 to 7 years, then comes trochlea at 10 to 11 years, and then comes lateral epicondyle at the 11 to 13 years. So there are four centers, that is capitulum at first year, trochlea at medial epicondyle at 6 to 7 years, then trochlea 10 to 11 years, and lateral epicondyle 11 to 13 years. All these four centers get fused to the shaft in case of male 14 to 15, while that of female 13 to 15. So is it clear about the humerus? Then next bone is the radius. Upper end of the radius comes at the 5 to 6 year in a female, while to 5 to 7 years in a male. While it gets fused to the shaft at the 13 to 14 years in case of female, while 14 to 15 years in case of male. The lower end of the radius come at the first year in a both sex, and it gets fused at the 16 to 17 years in the case of female, while that of the 17 to 18 years in case of male. Is it clear? So head 5 to 6 years in female, while 5 to 7 years in male, get fused in 13 to 14 years in female, while 14 to 15 years in male, while lower end at 1 year in both sexes, get fused at 16 to 17 years in female, while 7 to 19 years in male. Is it clear? Next bone is that of ulna. Upper end of the ulna gets, that is olecranon and process, at 9 to 11 years in female, while 11 to 12 years in male, and it gets fused to the chaff, that is 13 to 15 years in female, while to 15 to 16 years in male. While lower end, in a female, it comes 5 to 6 years, while in case of male, it comes at the 6 to 7 years. And it gets fused to the shaft at in case of female, that is 17 years, while in case of male, that is 18 years. Is it clear? So these are the upper extremity bone. Then you know that there are different carpal bones. So these bones are the scaphoid, trapezium, trapezoid, capitate, hamate, pisiform, triquil, and lunate. So that the first carpal bone is that of the capitate, that is 1 to 3 months, hamate 2 to 4 months, then triquitrum at 2 to 3 years, then lunate 4 to 5 years, then trapezium 4 to 6 years, then trapezoid again 4 to 6 years, scaphoid 5 to 6 years, pisiform 9 to 11 years. And the pisiform is the last carpal bone to build. So you can remember that is in the first year comes capitate and hamate. Triquitrum, you remember that three, for 2 to 3 years, triquitrum, lunate 4 to 5 years, trapezoid 4 to 6 years, in case of both sexes, while scaphoid 5 to 6 years, and that of pisiform at the 9 to 12 years. Then comes the metacarpal bone, that is appears at 2 years, and fusion occurs at the 15 to 17 years. So we first have seen that of the carpal bone. Carpal bone, we have seen capitate, hamate, triquitrum, lunate, trapezium, trapezoid, scaphoid, pisiform. Then we proceed for the metacarpals, appears at 2 years and get fused at the 15 to 17 years. Then comes phalanges, appears at the 2 to 3 years and fuses at the 17 to 18 years. So all these is the upper extremity. Then shoulder joint, from this you know that gets fused in a 16 to 17 years in a male, while to 15 to 16 years in a female. Then elbow joint, fusion occurs at a 15 to 16 years in a male, while in female 13 to 15 years. And a wrist joint, fusion occurs 18 to 19 years in male, while that of the 17 to 18 years in a female. So from this, you can conclude that the first joint to get the center get ossified in upper extremity is the elbow joint, that is in both sexes, it ranges from 13 to 16 years, and large joint in upper extremity is that of the rib joint, that is the 17 to 18. So you can remember that the in upper extremity, first joint to fuse is the elbow joint, that is the 13 to 16 years, then shoulder joint, 15 to 16, 17 years, and lastly, wrist joint, that is 17 to 19 years. So, if you want to take, if the exam, the alleged age is the 18 years, then you have to take the x-ray of a wrist joint, and you have to see, is it fused or not? And again, there are the stages of the fusion, and there is these stages of the fusion also given in a different textbook, that is the stage 0, 1, 2, 3. These are, and from that stages, you have to give the opinion about the fusion. Understood? So for your UG level, only remember that first joint in upper extremity to fuse is the elbow joint and last is the rib joint. Is it clear? Can I proceed? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Then next, we go to the lower extremity, that is the femur. Then head of the femur come at 1 year. Greater trochanter come at 4 years. Lesser trochanter comes at 14 years. And all these get fused to the shaft in case of female, 14 to 15 years, while that of male in 16 to 17 years. Lower end of a femur comes at the age of just before birth or just after the birth. That is about the lower end, and it gets fused between 15 to 16 years in case of female, while that of male in case of 16 to 17 years. Again, I'll repeat, head 1 year, greater trochanter 4 years, lesser trochanter 14 years, get fused 14 to 15 years in female, while in male 16 to 17 years, while that of the lower end appears, that is 9 to 10 months of intrauterine or just after the birth, and get fused in a female 15 to 16 years, while in male 16 to 17 years. Then next bone is the tibia, upper end before birth, that is the 9 to 10 intrauterine month or just after birth, same that of the lower end of the femur, and same that of the upper end of the tibia, that is the before, just before birth, that is 9 to 10 intrauterine or just after the birth. While it gets fused in case of female into the 15 to 16 years, while in case of male 16 to 17 years. Then lower end of a tibia comes at the first year and gets fused in case of female, that is 14 to 15 years, while in case of male, that is the 15 to 16 years. Next bone is the fibula. Fibula upper end appears at the 2 to 4, 5 years in both sexes, while it gets fused to that of the shaft in both sexes, that is the 14 to 16 years. While lower end of the fibula appears at the first year in both sexes and gets fused in case of female 13 to 15 years, while that of male 14 to 16 years. Is it clear? That is, upper end appears in both sexes 2 to 5 years and get fused 14 to 16 years in both sexes, while lower end appears at the first year and get fused in a female 13 to 15 years, while that of male 14 to 16 years. That is about the fibula. Then we will concentrate on a hip bone. The pubis gum, pubis get fused at the 10 to 9 years in both sexes. Then triradiate cartilage appear between 10 to 13 years in both sexes, while fusion appears in case of female on 14 years, while in male 14 to 15 years. That is about the triradiate cartilage. Then iliac crest appears in female 14 years, while that of in male in 16 years, while iliac crest get fused with the remaining iliac body, that is female in 17 to 19 years, while in male, that is 19 to 20 years. Then ischial tuberosity, that it get appear in a female 14 to 15 years, while in male 15 to 17 years, and in both sexes it get fused 20 years or above the 20 years. That is all about that of the hip bone. Again, the first, then the first is the pubis, comes 8 to 9 years both sexes. Then come triradiate cartilage, appears at the 10 to 13 years, while fusion in females 14 years, while in males 14 to 15 years. Then iliac crest appears 14 years in male, female, while in male 16 years, and fusion in female 17 to 19, while male 19 to 20 years. And lastly, that is the ischial tuberosity. Ischial tuberosity appears in a female 14 to 15 years, while in male 15 to 17 and get fused at 20 years. Then sacrum. Sacrum, that the appears from all 1 to 3 vertebrae, first, second, and third, 3 months of the intrauterine life, while 4 to 5 vertebrae in a 5 to 6 months of the intrauterine. That is the appearance. And you can easily see with this, then the fusion. Fusion start in the fusion from start below upward from 15 years to 25 years. You can see that arrow, and again I am showing this arrow, that here the this is not fused. There is the, you can see the line, this arrow, you can see the line, and it is not fused, means you can say that it is below 25 years. But it is the bone removed from a dead body. So in a dead body, you can give the age about 20, but from in a living, it is possible up to from an X-ray up to 21 years. That your concept must be clear. Is it clear? That is about the sacrum bone. That is from below upward 15 to 25. And you can see that it's not fused in this bone. So it must be below 25 years and above 15 years. Then skull bone. You know skull bone has a frontonally, posterior frontonally, that is fuses at appears at a birth at 1.5 months. Then anterior frontonally get fused at 2 years. While posterior lateral in a short period after the birth, and anterior lateral frontally gets used by the 6 months. Surfaces of the skull bone fuses on ectocranial surface first, but in the endocranial surface, though it starts late, but there is a uniform fusion and speedy fusion occur in an endocranial surface. Understood? And in many times, ectocranial it is incomplete. That is the basic thing about the skull bone. So now I'm showing you the figure of a frontanelli in a skull bone of a newborn child. That is the posterior frontanelli. It gets first. That the one birth or 1.5 months, up to 1.5 months. While anterior frontanelli get fused, that is by the 2 years. This is the anterior frontanelli. It gets fused up to the by the year of the 2 years. Then posterolaterally, short period of the one, and anterolaterally up to 6 months. So if the anterolateral is fused and the posterior anterior frontanelli is not fused, then you can say that is the it is between 6 years to 2 years. But it is possible only when a dead skull, fetal skull is available. Is it clear? That is the newborn skull is available. Then this is these are the different adult skull, and you know different suture. That is there is sagittal suture, or that is the vertical suture, or that is horizontal suture is known as the coronal suture. Then there is the parieto-occipital suture is there. So when did, and I already told, now you can see this is the ectocranial surface, and you can easily see the sutures. Means it is not fused. What we have seen that endocranial surfaces, though it gets fusion late, but it fuses uniform and speedy in the endocranial. But this figure is of a ectocranial surface. So metopic suture is the suture which is in between two frontal bones, and usually it gets fused between 2 to 8 years, and may it remain in some individual unfit. So metopic suture, it is the viva question. This suture is present in between two frontal bones. Usually it gets fused between 2 to 8 years, or it may remain unfused. Then coronal suture starts fusing at a 24 to 25 years and gets completed 40 to 50 years in an endocranial surface. While that of the sagittal suture starts fusing in a 24 to 25 and gets completed between the 45 to 50 years in case in an endocranial surface. That is same that of the coronal suture as well as the sagittal suture. Then is the lambdoid suture that fuses. Starts at the 25 to 26 years and gets completed between the 50 years to 55 years in endocranial surface. And last suture skull, that is the parietotemporal, it closes at the 7 years. So it is easy that the first suture, please unmute. Aishwarya Damre, unmute. Aishwarya, unmute. Aishwarya, unmute yourself. Metopic suture, 2 to 8 years, remains unfused. Sagittal suture and coronal suture both start 24 to 25 years and gets completed between 45 to 50 years. Then lambdoid suture start at 25 to 26 years, 27 years get fused 50 to 50, and last is the parietotemporal suture, and it gets closed at the 70 years. So that is about the skull bone. And the last, that is, if you see the inferior surface of the skull, there is basioccipit, gets fused with the basis sphenoid in case of female in 18 to 20 years, while in case of the male, 20 to 22 years. I cannot show this because it is the superior surface. In the inferior surface, there is the basioccipit. Basioccipit with basis sphenoid, it gets fused in a female 18 to 20 years, while in that of male, 20 to 22 years. Then sternum, first body appears 5 to 10 years, and fusion at that of the sacrum some below occurs from the 14 to 25 years. Then the zipper process appears 30 years and get fusion in the 40 years in both sections, and then appears center to the manubrium appears at the 5 months of the intertuber and gets fused at the 50 years. So you can say the body of the sternum appears by 5 to 10 months of intertuber life and get first fused from the 14 to 25 years. And then appears, that is the zipper process appears at the 3 years and get fused at the 40 years in both sections. And last is that of the manubrium appears at 5 months of intertuber and get fused 50 years. Is it clear? And next, age changes in the mandible, that there are two types of the angle, that is anatomical angle and that of the medico-legal angle. Anatomical angle, we have seen, is important in determination of the 6. This is the anatomical angle, while the inner angle is known as the medico-legal angle and helpful in case of the determination of the age. And you can see that it is more than 90 degrees in case of old age as well as in case of the children. But how you are going to differentiate if it is 90 degrees, you can say it is that of the adult, and you have to again see the mental foramina. If the mental foramina is at the middle of the ramus of the mandible and it is of a 90 degrees, then you can say that mandible is of an adult. But if it is more than 90 degrees, then you have to carefully see the mental foramina. If a mental foramina is at a lower level, then if you can see that it is of a child. And if it is the touching to the alveolar margin or touching to the teeth margin, then it is that of the old age. Is it clear? I am again repeating that if the angle is of a 90 degrees and mental foramina is in a more mid portion between this lower end and that of the alveolar edge, that is of adult. When the confusion occurs, when it is more than 90 degrees, in that case, you have to carefully see the mental foramina. If a mental foramina is close to the alveolar process, then it is that of an old age. If it is close at a lower level, then it is that of the newborn. Is it clear? So this figure easily explains age changes in a mandible. Then I have already said that bones are available in case of a dead. If whole bone is available, then with all these whatever I have told you, in a dead body, you can give the opinion that is up to 25 years, that is at 20 in a dead body. First, clear your concept. In a dead body, I am saying that you can give the range up to plus minus 2 years in up to 25 years. And after that, you can up to 25 years is the plus minus 1 year. And after 25 years, it is plus minus 2 years. But it is in a dead body. Now, if the person, individual has sent rape case, victim or accused case or another sent for examination for the age determination in live person, it is possible from the x-ray up to 21 years, and we usually give the opinion up to 21 years with a margin plus minus 1 year. And after that, we give the opinion that that individual, live individual is more than 21 years. So that's the thing. Understood? So how in a live you are going to see that you have to take an x-ray, and from the x-ray, how many ossificatory center has been appeared, are they fused or not, and from that you are going to give the opinion. And there are different formulae I have told, that is Bruelich Pyle Atlas, Tanner Whitehouse Atlas, or Jeet and Kulkarni method, or nowadays you all are techno-sci-fi students, that there is apps are there, and whatever finding you get that this center is ossified, this is fused, then you have to feed that information in that app and app give the approximate age. So, but you have to first take the x-ray and see what are the ossification center appear and what are the ossification center has been fused. So I am giving you, these are the at a 2 years like this, at a 4 year, these carpal bones are present, at a 7 years, then 10 year rejoin, 14 year rejoin, and the 53 year rejoin. You can easily see. So usually it is seen that the up to 4 year number of the carpal bone, that is here are the 2 years, so it is up to 2 years. You can see that the lower end, small ossification center has been here, almost the ossification center at the lower end of the radius has been. So here you can say a single line, while this is the, but it is appeared, but it is of a stage 2, but not fused. So these are the different stages are there, 0, 1, 2, 3, like this. And from that you have to, again in say 7 years, the increase in a carpal bone you can see like this. And in an adult you can see all are, and it is fused. Here 14 years, all center, lower end of radius, lower end of ulna, all carpal bones has been appeared, but it is not yet fused, because you know that the lower end, which is the last center to fuse, in upper extremity is the last joint, is that of the ridge joint, and it fuses 18 to 19. From here you can see that it is the approximate, because because it is from the you know the age, that's why the exact age is equal. But from this you can give that is 40 above 14 years and below 18 years. Like this information you can take. Understood? Again, you can see the phalanges, the carpal bone, head has been appeared, but it is not used. Then you can read the phalanges also. You can see the phalanges centers has been appeared, but it is not fused. So you can give that it is between 16 to 18 years. Like this, you have to apply your knowledge. Same thing, I already, that is the adult wrist joint. Yes, Power, unmute yourself. Then adult elbow, you can see all the centers, and in a second x-ray, you can see the here, this adult elbow, that is all are fused, while in a pediatric elbow, you can see the centers has been appeared, but not yet fused. Is it clear? Next, same thing, that of the elbow joint, that this lower end of the, it is the humerus centers, that is medial epicondyle, lateral epicondyle, then trochlea and capitulum has been appeared, but not yet fused. Also, you can see the upper end of the radius has been appeared, but not fused. Also, olecranon process has been appeared, but not fused. Like these are the x-rays. Then this is the x-ray of a pediatric hip joint. You can see the femoral head, but a greater trochanter has been not been appeared. Like this, also there is triradiate cartilage, but ischial fibrosity and the this has been not, pubis has not been appeared. So like this, you can see this. This is that the all has been seen, that the pubis has been appeared. All three centers, you can see the first, only the femoral head has been, while in this, all the femoral head, greater trochanter, lesser trochanter has been appeared. Then normal pediatric skeletal develop of the knee joint, you can see this is the lower end of the femur, upper end of the tibia and fibula, and how it gets fused from a 6 month, 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, and a 4 year. And this is again the unfused knee joint. That is lower end of the femur as well as upper end of the tibia and fibula. So, it is the conclusion. You should always remember that with the scientific examination, we can give only the opinion in a range. You cannot give the exact age. And again, age estimation from ossification center depend on various factors such as race, sex, nutrition, food habit, geographical area. And again, we have to give the opinion on our scientific medical knowledge and authentic references. I already told that you have to quote that I have taken this from a this and this standard textbook. If you have taken from Reddy, you can tell from Reddy. If you have taken from a Nandi, you can take. If you have taken from Bardale, you can quote that I have taken from this standard textbook. And what happens if you are given the range 16 to 18 years? And it's the scientific basis. And codes also, because you know that 16 years is below 16 years, that it becomes a juvenile and punishment is different. Above 16 years, it is considered as an adult, punishment is different. And the code can take the advantage of that because you are not firm. It is, okay? You are not saying that it's exact 16 or exact 18. So the opposite lawyer will take a chance of this, and from this he can say that he is below or she is below 16 years and there will be no punishment even if the accused has done the serious offense like a murder. And you get frustrated because you have given your opinion according to your scientific knowledge. But still the court lawyer can take the advantage of that range. But we cannot help it because we have to give the opinion in a range. Usually 6 month range, 25 or after 25 years plus minus 2 years, or what I have said that the this is applicable in case of the dead. In a living, again I'm saying we can give up to 21 years plus minus 1 year, and after that we give the opinion that it usually is about 21 years. Is it clear? So that's all about today's lecture. Thank you. Again, I'm requesting all of you, always unmute when you are listening. Is it clear? Understood? Understood? So today we have
yes, sir.
We have seen the important topic, that is the age estimation from the ossification center.